Hello friends, this video is about the December 2020 FMG exam for foreign medical graduates. So we all have prepared for the exam of August also, but the exam came very difficult, very atypical, and a lot of us could not succeed. So before I discuss the revision plan, I must suggest you one thing, that let the grief be over. We have already, you know, spent a lot of time in grief and sadness since 12th of September. I think let's call it off now. Enough of grief, enough of sadness. And anyway, this exam was not a clear assessment of the preparation you have done actually, because the exam was very atypical. Now, how to approach the December exam? Shall I write all the notes once again? New? No, that's not the case. Please understand one thing. We are only left with 70 days and we'll be appearing the exam. In 70 days, you cannot build the castle once again. Okay? Yes, you can repair the castle. You can revisit certain parts. You can strengthen certain parts. And that's the way to go about it. So that's why I'm sharing this information with you. That please do not make up this your mind that you are going to write everything afresh. Okay, you have already attended your classes, or you know, you may have done certain other resources to build up your concepts for the August exam. You have to strengthen those concepts only, add on to those concepts, revise those concepts in a systematic way, and we will be approaching the December exam with this strategy. Now, which is the subject I should start with? Number one, start the clinical subjects. Due to time constraints in the MCA FMG segment, medicine, pediatric, orthopedics, derma, psychiatry, you know, these kind of subjects get little less time actually. That's the trend actually, which has been going on, but August exam has really, you know, changed the trend big time. So first of all, you must pick up the clinical subjects. Don't go to the first year subjects again because you like them, you enjoy them. Don't pick up them once again and start with them. So the first and foremost thing is to bring your, you know, the clinical subject notes out, okay? Number one should be medicine. Guys, medicine has been one of the major chunk of the paper which they asked. And our medicine is little weaker in most of the students I'm talking about in FMD segment. So how to approach medicine? Don't go from cover to cover of a topic like that, because that would take a lot of time and we are left with 70 days. Okay. So do the cardiovascular system questions first, the clinical statement based questions, and then you read the relevant explanation given over there and that question and add on that concept to your existing notes. That's the way to go about it, rather than really, you know, doing every, you know, inch of the book from first page to the last page, because that is a very vast subject and you cannot handle that in, you know, in that way. So you already have attended, you know, some classes, some other resources for medicine. Okay. But now you should do clinical statement based questions more and retrospectively read the explanation and add on to your notes. That will be a wonderful thing. Now, do not do only medicine in the whole day. It will fatigue you up because, you know, it is sometimes a very overwhelming subject also for some of the students. I would advise you to divide your day into three parts. How? Number one part is the morning part you devoted for the clinical subject like medicine, then pediatric, then orthopedics, then psychiatry, then dermatology, and then go to, you know, surgery, ops, gynae, like that. The morning chunk, let it go like that. In that, you do the clinical questions and read the explanation, read your notes. If anything additional is coming out, create a supplementary copy and add on that concept or any extra information to that supplementary copy. Do not spoil your original notes you have, okay? Your original notes are still having a huge value, okay? But just add one more supplementary copy, and in that copy, write the extra point you're gathering by doing the MCQs so that you can revise them later in a systematic way. So first part of the day, approximately till lunchtime, is for the clinical subjects actually. Now post lunch, pick up a subject which you were really comfortable about. For example, pathology. You know, some pathology or maybe physiology or anything. Do that subject now again and revise the notes and go very quick now. Okay, don't really spend a lot of time in revising only one respiratory system you are revising for continuous 2 days. Not like that. Go quick now. You know what kind of question are being asked, and you can absorb those points in a little easy way, in a little systematic manner. Okay, but the point is quick focused revision. When I say focused revision, I have got two requests from you. Number one, the mobile phone should be switched off, because when you revise, the mobile phone cannot be on. Because if you are revising with mobile phone on and WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram is going on simultaneously, maybe for academic purpose only, but that dilutes the impact the revision can create on our brain. Okay, so the first and foremost fundamental rule of any study period is that your mobile phone should be switched off. Okay, now the second thing I request from you is that take breaks only after 2 hours of continuous sitting. Do not sit for 45 minutes and go, and take a break. Study for 2 hours, only then take a break. Be systematic. Be systematic. Now, most of you are studying on your own. You don't have any, classes or anything attending. You have to make your 70 days, a disciplined segment over in your life. Okay. Now, continue the physiology or pathology till dinner. Now, after the dinner is over, take rest. Okay, for 45 minutes, 1 hour, do not do anything. Refresh, whatever social media you have to use, maybe for seeing academic thing, keep it for that. Keep one hour for social media, maybe YouTube video, maybe anything like on Telegram or anything like on Facebook, club over here, anywhere you want to see, just go in that 1 hour only. Let's pledge today, only 1 hour post dinner or during dinner and post dinner is reserved for the social media kind of activities. Maybe it's a YouTube video or anything like Instagram or Telegram group or anything. Okay, after that, keep the mobile mostly off. Otherwise, it will distract you a lot. Okay, now after you have rested after dinner, now it's the time to do multiple choice questions. Guys, one big change in strategy after August and for December exam is that you have to spend every day minimum 2-2.5 hours for MCQs only. That's very, very important, because if we analyze the paper of August, you will get to know that August exam was not that difficult. It was actually a very lengthy exam. So our major problem in the August exam, which at least I could understand now, it was a high level exam, but it was not that difficult in all the questions. It was actually a lengthy exam and we were not having the practice of solving the MCQs. And that's why we got stuck up. Our brain was not able to focus. Till the time we read the last line of the MCQ, we forgot the first line. We were not able to catch the keywords in the MCQs, and that's how we really, could not reach the right choice over there. So by practicing doing MCQs, we'll have, preparation for the December exam, that we'll know how to solve lengthy questions. Okay. Now, so every day, 2-2.5 hours should be reserved only for solving the MCQs from, those resources which have got clinically enriched statement-based questions. Okay. Now, every time you do an MCQ, like you do 10 MCQ, 1 or 2 MCQ you will really like a lot. They will be really worth repeating. So please tick them. If any salient feature is coming out of that, shifted that information to your supplementary copy, you revise that time also. But certain MCQs would demand revision also. So out of 10, maybe 2 or 3, mark them that they are worth revising once again when you pick up the revision. Okay. So let me summarize again. The day can be divided into 3 parts. The morning half for the new clinical subject knowledge. The post-lunch time is for the revision of the old subject which you are really strong at, like pathology, pharmacology, or maybe biochemistry, physiology, whatever. Okay, but keep doing it faster. And every day, 2-2.5 hours should be reserved for MCQs only. Okay. Now, anything else I need to do extra? Yes. Please see a lot of clinical images. Images were there over there. So where should I see the images? Please go to the standard reference books for surgery, for example. Go to Love and Bailey and see the standard images. And a lot of images of surgery were from Love and Bailey only, if you know it. Okay. Similarly, for pathology, there were a lot of images go to the pathology book like Robbins or Hirschhorn and see the image, but read the explanation given and try to create a visual memory in your head that what has been explained about that particular image. Okay, so images have to be strengthened. Okay, now shall I add a lot of information to anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, microbiology, pharmacology, PSM? No, the notes would remain same. The faculties everywhere have given you, you know, wonderful notes were there. You know, have faith. Let's keep on revising. You may have this question, sir. These very few questions came out of these topics or this subject. Shall I leave them? No, we cannot leave them. The reason are two. Number one, they make the fundamental basics of understanding of clinical subjects. Number two, there can be again one-liner. Some of the one-liners again may be enhanced in the December paper. And these six subjects would be giving us a lot of one-liners also. Please don't ignore them. Okay, forensic medicine also, the same kind of notes you have, you know, you need not really invest a lot of energy. Your energy has to be invested more into clinical subjects, which are our weaker subject. Guys, orthopedics and pediatric are main subjects. We have been ignoring them and they have to be given due respect over there. We should see a lot of radiology images. Try to imagine the situation as a doctor would imagine. This is what paper demanded, you know, from you, that you should imagine situation, correlate the information clinically with pathology or radiology, and then tell the answer. So let's start doing it. Okay. Now, what are my timelines over here? The timeline is, please understand this, till 15th of November, you must finish two revisions of everything. When I say two revision, I'm saying that the clinical subject, which you'll be reading for the first time, that has to be read two more time after that. Okay. And the subject which you're stronger at, which you're doing in the post lunch half, you'll be doing one more time, So post lunch half subject, one revision, then one more revision. In the morning of the clinical things which you're doing, you should do three times. The first reading now, then one more reading, then one more reading. To do this, you have to be quick and focused. Do not spend too much of time on revising one data and just taking too much, like you take 10 days to revise pathology. It is not going to really serve the purpose. You should spend, you know, three and a half days, 2 days for three revision of pathology. That's a much, much, much better idea. Okay. So the idea is that you should have the, you know, visual, you know, journey of those concepts, notes and questions multiple number of times. Guys, please do remember that multiple quick revisions are better than single exhaustive revision. Multiple quick revisions are better than single exhaustive revision. Yes, provided you are focused during revision. For that, mobile phone has to be kept switched off. Guys, some strategy formation has to be there. It's something I'm sharing, what I could understand, what I would have done if I would have been in your shoes. You can titrate the strategy as per your own needs also. Some people are like early morning risers. Some people read till late. That's fine. You can titrate your which hour you want to keep for MCQs. That is your this thing. But my idea is to tell you, divide the day into three parts. One, to build up new information of clinical sciences. One, to revise the information of basic and paraclinical sciences. And 2.5 hours for the MCQs. But most important thing is, let's move forward from it. We have already spent a lot of days in, you know, thinking about what to do, how to do. It's a time to do better. Now let's move forward. Whatever had to happen has happened. Let's cross over and let's start the preparation again, because we are having 70 days to revise and strengthen our concepts. Particularly in clinical sciences, we have to strengthen our concept better. Okay. Please keep motivating your friends also. When you hold hand with other people who are sailing in the same boat, you will also feel strengthened. Okay. And thank you very much. Do not, you know, leave this, you know, your dream, which you have of fulfilling, you know, a license actually of practicing medicine in this country. And we will do our level best. One fear which will bother you in these 70 days. What if I fail again? This will be, I am a student, I'll face this again and again in my head. What if a December exam comes difficult? What if December exam is super clinical again? And I'm again getting stuck up at 148, 149 or something like that. My humble suggestion to you is, and which I also practice, is that only way to go about it is a thought in your head that I am going to do my best and I leave the rest to God. Let's be submissive over here. Let's do our best. And let's forget about the rest. Let's leave the decision to the God. At least do so much hard work that nature is forced to bless your hard work. Okay. First, are you ready to do the hard work or not? That's my question is. And I'm sure each FMG has got a lot of internal strength and they would really, you know, go forward from here. You guys are very, very strong people inside. I know you have survived in harshest circumstances out of the country with a different language, different food and different people all around you guys. You survived there. This is your internal strength. This is your internal strength. And this internal strength would help you to cross over from this place to the preparation of the December 2020 exam. So my best wishes to all and God bless you all. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.